Hey everybody, it's Karen and Alex here tonight. Hello, hello, hello. How are y'all? We're good, we're good. We're having a good day. We're sick of the wind. We're ready for the wind to go away, blow away. I don't know if you can say that, but I wish the wind would blow away. I'm really over it. I want my kids to go out and play. That would be nice. We want the dog to be happy outside, not run away from the wind. Had to scoot Alex over. She was too far away. So, we have a fun card for y'all tonight. It's called the Impossible card.
Ooh.
Where are you going? You just got here. She's running away. She doesn't like me anymore. I must not have put the deodorant on.
Oh, whatever.
So anyway, I feel like I have to scoot over because she's way over there. So I'm going to scoot way over here. There she is! So this is May 2nd. And the Share What You Love suite is available to customers. I'm so excited about that. Last week I showed you all about it. So I'll just give you a little recap. It's the Share What You Love suite. And here's the photos of some of the cards. And then in this suite, you can get the Just Getting Started bundle, which has a stamp set, very vanilla cardstock, two ink pads in the new style, an e-block, and for free, you get note cards and envelopes.
Hi, Donna.
And then the next one is a little more, please, bundle. That's the one I like. Well, I like them all. But you get the two wonderful stamp sets, the package of very vanilla cardstock. Then you get real pretty cardstock that comes in Grapefruit Grove. Mm-hmm. I said it right. Mint Macaron, Old Olive, and Rich Razzleberry. And then you get the doilies. Down here you get the Grapefruit Grove ink pad.
Mm-hmm.
You get the fun velveteen ribbon.
It's so much fun to play with.
What's that? Oh, is that the pearls? You get the pearls. I can't see.
Yes, the artisan pearls.
Then for free, you get the note cards. And you get this really cute little box that has embellishments in it.
Okay.
Then, if you want more, what?
Like, of course,
I always have to have more. Give me more! I love this Gotta Have It All bundle. So in the Gotta Have It All bundle, you get the two stamp sets, very vanilla cardstock, the real pretty cardstock, the pearlized doilies.
They're so pretty.
And this beautiful, beautiful designer series paper. The Grapefruit Grove ink pad.
Good
the
job.
Velveteen ribbon.
Ooh.
The pearls.
Uh-huh.
Then you get this wonderful dynamic impressions folder that has a beautiful flower in the middle. And then for free, you get the Statement of My Heart stamp set. You get a set of envelopes for free,
mm-hmm.
and then you also get this box with the beautiful embellishments in it.
It is a nice box, and the embellishments are gorgeous.
Aren't they? Mm-hmm. I agree. So I was playing with the in colors. I wanted to make a few cards
mm-hmm.
out of the in colors, and this one came out a little dark, so you really, it's hard to see,
mm-hmm.
But I'm going to put that up really close. Ooh, can you see it really close? It says, I'm lucky to have you, to have a friend like you.
Hi, Missy.
Hi, Missy. And I used the basket weave, which has, that was a celebration item.
Yes.
And it's now in the new catalog.
Mm-hmm.
So anyways, this is our
blueberry
bushel.
Mm-hmm.
And I did it in the grapefruit grove. takes me 3 tries. Ooh, lucky lips.
Lovely.
Lovely lipstick.
Lovely lipstick.
Okay.
It's a nice pinky red.
I think so.
It's more
more
pinky than red, I would think.
Uh-huh. I agree. And then this one is the Call Me Clover.
Yep.
Okay. See, she knows them better than I do. Yay, Alex.
Nerdy.
And then this one is the pineapple something. Punch.
Punch. There you go.
Oh, she said punch. How about a Hawaiian punch? Oh, sorry. She's too young for that. Only my sister Donna might know what that means. Huh, Donna? Maybe your mom.
Oh, hi, Debbie.
Hi, Debbie. Glad to see you're on. Hopefully Joe joins us soon. Mm-hmm. I know she's looking forward to being on. So those are cards, fun in colors. Oh my goodness, I just love them. And like I said, that blue one's a little hard to see, but
you know
I still
what they
like
need?
Them.
Winkastella.
I agree. They need something.
Everything's better with Winkastella.
So these were fun cards to make.
Donna says, love the green.
Oh, I know, right? That green is so pretty. I love it too, sis.
I think my favorite is the grapefruit grove.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
I seem to use a lot of it with this new bundle.
Mm-hmm. It's so pretty.
So, and I don't know, this yellow is growing on me. The pineapple punch, to me it's awful bright, but then after using it a couple times, I'm kind of liking it.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of growing on me.
Mm.
Other news. I don't think there's other news other than if you want a new catalog from me, please let me know and I'll be more than happy to send one to you. Yes, Alex. Oh, yes. Friday night is our Project Ink.
Hi, Christy.
Hi, Christy. We have Project Ink once a month, the first Friday of the month. And
you make?
It's just a class that you come to Pizza Hut, and for $10, you make 3 cards and a 3D item, which is a lot. But we make simple projects. We don't make anything too difficult.
No, I get yelled at if I do.
Yes, because it's just supposed to be come and have fun and socialize and not really make hard projects because that's more class oriented. And this is just a social.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that's what we should call it. Project Ink Social Hour.
Social Project Ink. Yeah, we'll work on the name.
Anyways, we're not looking to change the name, just looking to...
Hi, Joe.
Joe, you found us. Yay. So glad. Okay. So, I'm trying to think if there's anything other than the catalogs that I need to tell you about. Other than I have just been, and Alex, has been whipping out cards like crazy with this new bundle. Oh, well, so we've been working a lot in the studio. We've been pulling retired card stock and redoing the cards. Well, she walked into a huge mess today. My husband actually put in my other counter for me and cupboards.
I'm so excited.
And everything was on our table, so we actually had to do a lot of cleaning. Donna, you'll hop on the red eye? Come on. I can't wait. Anyways, we had to do a lot of cleanup and it's still very overwhelming. We're also cleaning out a bedroom for Savannah. And so I've got a lot of that in my studio. We also got a new dryer today. It's been an overwhelming day, to say the least. But we did it. Alex did it. I just played with the baby all day. So anyways, without further ado.
I played with Savannah too.
Yes, you did. This is called an impossible card. Now, it's really hard to show it this way. I'm trying to show it. So, this... I don't know how else to show And that's the back. And it stands up.
See? It's impossible.
So when we get the other... So you kind of saw the pictures at the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And this is that one was my Alex's, and this one is mine. We're not going to judge or say anybody's is better because we know Alex's is, but that's okay. So anyways, that's the front. Shush up. And that's the back. Okay, and then again, it just stands up. So let's switch you over.
Joe says you got new cabinets.
I did, Joe. I got one new cabinet. And then we put a countertop on top of it. Mm-hmm. So I have a cutting counter now. So we're going to switch you around. Actually, Alex is. Ho ho! So now
we're getting pretty good at this stuff.
Okay. So
see? They're impossible.
So see how it is? And so when I fold it down, that's what it looks like. Unless you get a picture, it's. I don't know how to show this really well.
I don't know.
Let's see. Oh, well, I hope you guys get the gist. Okay, so I'm going to show you step by step how to do this. Okay?
Yes.
And if I goof up, I apologize. There may be goof ups. There is a tutorial on my blog. Do you hear me? I hit the table all the time. That's how I talk. I know.
Christy okay. says both are gorgeous.
Thank you, Christy. So I want you to see that this... I'm terrible at this camera stuff. Sorry. That is the template. I'm making y'all dizzy because I'm dizzy. Okay, that's the template we're going to use. But I'm going to show you how to do it.
Okay, you can find this photo on the tutorial as well.
Yeah, that photo is on the tutorial.
Hi, Amanda.
As well as other photos. Okay. Alex was really good. She did a really thorough job. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is cut our cardstock, which I already did a regular card size. Mm-hmm. So this is cut at 5.5 by 8.
Mm-hmm.
And a half.
Hi, Molly.
I'm going to cut this down. I just mimic what she says. I'm a parent. Hi, Molly. Hi, Amanda. I'm serious. I love you guys. Thank you all for joining us. We're really grateful to have you. Okay.
One could say you're grapefruit grew.
I'm grapefruit.
You're grateful grew. I also make bad puns.
Okay, anyways. On with the show.
Did I distract you?
Yes. This is cut at 5.5, and we're going to cut it at 4.25.
Uh-huh.
Okay, got my handy Stampin' Up! Trimmer here. All right, I'm going to put that piece aside.
Okay.
So now what we want to do is score this at 2 1/8, right?
No. Yes, 2 1/8, sorry.
Aye. We're going to goof up already.
You think I know what I'm doing.
A goof up will be had, I promise. I don't know what I'm saying. Okay. So now we're going to go to the 5.5 side, and we're going to go to 2 3/4,
mm-hmm.
Okay? And so I have my marks up there. And we're going to take our scoring tool, and we're just going to score to that middle 2 1/8 mark, okay? We aren't going to go beyond that. And actually, I'm doing it wrong. We're not going to score. We're going to take the cutter tool, and we're just going to go to that 2 1/8 mark. And so on the side here, you can also see 2 1/8,
mm-hmm.
And that's where you're going to cut to. All right, so now I'm going to turn it around,
mm-hmm.
And I'm going to go to 1 inch on each side.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm, again, going to take my cutter and just go to that 2 1/8 mark, okay? And that gets me right to my line. And I'm going to just flip it over. Well, I don't have to. I can do it here. I have an inch on both sides, and I forget that sometimes. So I'm going to take my inch.
I didn't know that was there.
Woo! She just learned something new. I love this trimmer. Oh, my gosh. Okay, so I'm just going to the 2 1/8 mark right there on the ruler. And it's perfect, okay? So now what you want to do is flip one side to the back and score it. I mean, crease it. And make it really crisp.
Burnish it.
Burnish! That's the word. And then you're going to flip this to the forward side. And you're going to burnish it again. And look at that. That is the base for the impossible card.
It's standing up on its own.
See that? Isn't that cool, y'all? I'm starting with the y'alls again. Okay. So now I'm going to set this aside. Okay. Now we've got to cut our layers. All right. So I've already cut one layer. This is cut at 2 5/8 by 4 1/8. All right. Now I'm going to do a little scoring. The first score mark is at 7/8. Right, Alex?
Yep.
She did the first one. She was the guinea pig. So I'm going to score that at 7/8, and then I'm going to turn it, and I'm going to score it at 2 inches.
Yep.
Okay. At 2 inches. And I don't need to come all the way across, okay, and have that crease. I can go just right to that 7/8 inch score line. Okay. And then what you want to do is take your scissors and you want to cut off the 2 1/8 inch square, correct?
There is a larger square.
By 1/8 of an inch.
Yep.
Okay. So we don't cut the 2 inch side off.
Nope.
We cut the 2 1/8 inch side off. And I do things a little slowly because I don't want to mess up on the first time around. So as you can see, now I goofed.
What did you do? Oh yeah, you did.
I cut the wrong side. Guess what? That's what we have scissors for. I can just take my snips, I mean my scissors. Oh, we've got this pesky fly that I tried to kill earlier, and I couldn't get him. And now he's back.
I touched it.
And he is bothering me again.
Just ignore the fly.
Ignore the fly. How can you ignore the fly? Okay, so that piece is gone. And guess what? They're even. Okay. So, all right, that's that. Now, it's the designer series paper time. And again, this is out of the Share What You Love bundle.
Look, watch.
I know, it's pearlized.
Isn't that cool?
Okay, so now this is a layer. So we are going to cut this one.
At 2 1/2 by 4.
At 2 1/2.
Yep.
So I'm going to just make one big cut. 2 1/2 by 4 inches.
Yep.
I'm glad she remembers because I'm trying to look at our notes and I'm not getting it. Okay, so the last one we cut at 7/8 or scored at 7/8. Let me tell you, whatever side you want facing up, don't cut on that side. Turn it over. Okay? So I want this side facing up, and I'm going to turn it over. Ask us how we know. Okay.
Ask how many times it took us to figure that one out.
Yeah. So this one I'm going to score at 1 3/4. The last one, remember, was 1 7/8.
No, it was just at 7/8.
Oh, it was just at, see? Goof up. It was at 7/8. So this one we're going to score at
3/4.
Okay, so I got to get it even on my lines. And this one's going to be a little harder, but that's okay. So I'm going to score that down. And then I'm going to turn it. And the last one was scored at 2 inches.
So you're going to do it at 1 7/8.
1 7/8. Listen to her. She's so good over here. I'm so glad because, I would just go crazy. 1 7/8. And again, I don't have to go all the way across. Okay.
There is a bigger side to this.
Yes.
You want to make sure you cut the bigger one.
We want to cut the bigger one off, mm-hmm. not the little one.
No.
That's what I'm going to do right now, is cut that bigger side off, and then I still have one more to do. But that's okay. Hopefully we'll do it right. Okay. So that's one, and when I talk layer, that's what I mean. I want that to layer right on there. Now, let's test this to make sure it's going to work for me. Because like I said, I got the right side up. Score! It worked, Alex. It worked.
I'm so glad.
Okay.
Christy says, love that paper. Love the whole
Me too. Oh, I have not used this DSP so much. Okay, so again, we've cut this at
2.5,
and we're going to cut this at 4.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now.
You can just take this and line it up.
You can. Excuse me, I got a hiccup. Yes, you sure can, but we're not going to do that. We're going to do it this way.
A helpful tip is that once you get your little templates, then you don't need to do this every time. You can just use your templates and cut out the little.
Yes, you can. But Karen's not doing it that way.
I know.
I like to do things.
Karen wants to be different.
I like to do things the hard way. Okay, and then we scored it again at 2 3/4? No.
3. Did you do it at 3/4? And then you go to 1 7/8.
1 7/8?
Mm-hmm.
See, I need her to tell me. Fly. I'm sorry. Maybe you should turn us off because you don't want to see me swatting flies. And what's really funny is like, this fly, we've hit it with our hands, like, many times.
You would think it would get the hint.
Right? Or and die.
It's not.
It must be cold.
Mm-hmm. It is sort of chilly outside.
Again, if you didn't hear me at the beginning, I'm over this wind.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, it is chilly. I'm ready for some warmth. Oh, no.
Oh, no. Oh, good.
No, it's not good.
What did you do?
Maybe I was supposed to. I don't know.
Did you cut off the wrong side?
I don't know.
Oh, Karen.
All right.
This is why we use the template.
Let me use the template.
Let
okay.
me see what happened. It's like, I don't know what happened.
But it's the wrong way.
Because
I need it to be this way. So
okay, make sure that's the right one.
It is.
Layers up.
It is.
Okay.
It is.
I have faith in you.
You better, because I'm going to just chop it. I get so frustrated when I don't do things right. But guess what? It's better that it happens to me on video so you guys can see what happens. And then you guys hopefully won't make the same mistake. So I think you cut one side the right way
mm-hmm.
and one side the wrong way.
Mm-hmm.
I think I told you wrong. If you know what I mean, you're going to cut one side of the DSP upside down and one side of the DSP right side up. Ta-da! Okay. Whew, feeling better.
No.
Did I cut the wrong one?
Yes. I told you. It's supposed to have a little bit more card right there.
Okay, so guess what? Alex is going to cut that for me off screen because
make sure it's the right
gonna
template.
Move right along. Okay, so then I cut a little layer.
Okay, now
to go on here. So I'm gonna have a little layer on here. Do you have the right one?
Where's the other one?
I threw it away. Watch. When you don't like what happens, throw it away. I'll have to clean that up later. All right. So then I made another layer. Now these measurements will be on my blog.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't remember these measurements, but I could measure them if I... Let's see. They are...
2 3/3/8, 1 7/8, and 3 1/4.
See?
Thank you, Anna.
Alex knows. Okay, so let's get back to work. Now I'm going to stamp, okay? I'm going to do a little stamping on this while Alex is cutting for me. Mm-hmm. And I think, is this my boo-boo piece?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to throw it away. Okay. I'm going to do a little stamping. All right. I am going to, in basic black ink, get that where you can see it.
Memento.
Okay. They got rid of our basic black ink.
Mm-hmm.
We just have Memento and Stazon now. So if you hear me say basic black, remember that I'm just trying to say Memento. Okay, so I'm just going to tap that on there. And then I'm going to stamp it. And that sentiment just says thank you. And all of these stamps are out of the Love What You Do. That's backwards. Okay, is that right? Love What You Do stamp set. I'm telling you, I'll probably use this stamp set next week as well. I just love it. And I'm going to stamp. I was going to damp. Oh, they didn't turn out so great. But that's okay. Let me get a little more ink on that. That's okay. I didn't stamp cut extra. Let me show you what I'm going to try to do. Do you think I can do this?
Yes.
Do you think I can overlap it?
Oh, what are you trying to do?
Did you hear Alex? Oh, what are you trying to do?
What?
Yay! It's blurry!
It's photopolymer.
I tried. Okay, then you'll never know. A handmade card has to have mistakes on it, or people will never know that you made it. Okay, I'm going to take the Rich Razzleberry, and I'm just going to go over those just to give them a little color. Am I right that a handmade card needs a little love? And that's how you get the love. Okay, so I'm just stamping the ink off of that. That's just what I do before I wash it. Okay, so this is all ready. I'm going to go ahead and put... You have to be careful with some of these ink pads and not get them all over your hands, because you will for sure get it all over your cards. Okay, so I'm going to lay this down so you can see what I'm going to do. I'm going to move that mat. Okay, I've got my snail. And snail is just adhesive. It's snail is an acronym for,
I don't remember.
I'll have to figure that one out again. I'm going to layer this on here. Now we only have like an eighth of an inch around. It's a Stampin' Up! Acronym. And then I'm going to take this. And I have to put a little more snail on because it's dry here. And my cards tend to come apart because of the dryness.
Mm-hmm. Simple, neat, affordable, in line.
Simple, neat, affordable, in line. That's what snail stands for. All right.
There you go.
Alex, cut these for me. Aren't they beautiful? Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and tape these together. I love my Alex. She is such a great helper. I don't know what I would do without her some days. Go crazy.
Probably.
Days like today, when too much is going on and I just want to go crazy.
No, but you didn't, and you made a very pretty card. Huh.
Yeah, but look, see?
What?
I made a very pretty card. Only because you made a very pretty card. We're gonna gush. She just knows my woes of today. I have and love and adore my grandchildren. Don't get me wrong.
They're so sweet.
But they were very needy today. And I must have heard my name a million times.
I got here and she was like, I'm over it.
Nana, 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 Nana.
We did play Uno.
We did? Yeah. Mm-hmm. We're teaching Weston how to play Uno. Owen loves it. And I want them to be able to play it together this summer. So, and Wyatt played a little bit.
Mm-hmm. He was getting good at picking colors out, yeah.
Yeah. So, okay.
It was very funny when someone else was winning, though.
So when somebody else is winning, you know, they all get a little, winning. It is hilarious. Okay. But, yeah, I think the wind has gotten to everybody because it's been days and days and days of wind. Okay, so this one now is just going to layer right on here.
Woohoo!
Okay. Look at that cute card. Okay, we're not done yet, though.
Cool.
We are going to take this other piece of cardstock that is, again, 5.5 by 4.25. And we're just going to take about 1/2 inch.
Mm-hmm.
Right, you could do a little more. Maybe I'll do a little more this time. Let's go 3/4 of an inch this time. Just to see. Just for giggles. Because I like to giggle. Okay. Mm-hmm. Anyways. We're going to lay that down. Now I have something else I'm going to do once I do that. Oh, I got to make sure when I do this, okay, you kind of want to lay this together. And that way you get the adhesive where you need it. You don't want the adhesive right there.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
You need to be up.
Oh, I was just showing the edge. Okay. You don't want the adhesive all over the place because it'll stick to whatever surface you're sticking it on then. And so this is just to kind of keep the card together, to keep it stable. But guess what? We're going to decorate it. So I took, remember I told you to use all your DSP? Mm-hmm. Well, I took and cut some flowers out earlier. I'm going to pull some dimensionals in. And I'm going to, I don't know, do you like that blue one on there? Or should I maybe just go with the purples? The rich raspberries. Let me grab a glue dot.
I like the blue one.
I do too. I think it's kind of pretty. It kind of adds to it, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I want a glue dot. Because I'm also going to bring in... I cut a little greenery as well.
Ooh.
Earlier. So
pretty.
Let's see which way do I want this. Okay, one more glue dot. Dimensional. Okay. And then see, you can just add that right there in the center. And that just adds a little bit of color to your card.
Mm-hmm.
And now let me get that. So I hope that we explain this card well.
Mm-hmm.
We're not seeing very many comments. I hope everybody's just enamored with looking at the card and watching us make it.
Mm-hmm. We can link the tutorial below too.
Okay. So do you have any more comments coming in or?
No.
Did everybody leave us? Is it quiet?
Yeah, for the most part.
Hi, okay.
Christy.
Hey, Christy. So I want to let you know that last week's winner was Christy. Yay. And this week we're giving away a package. Oops. Right there. A package of Baker's Twine. So please, I forgot to say this at the beginning. Go in and like us. Share us. And a comment. Christy's excited. I know she is.
Mm-hmm.
Saying too much. Like us, share us, comment, please.
Giveaway ends tomorrow at noon.
Okay. So, we're back.
Did you miss us?
I hope you guys really liked that card. It was fun. It was
I
fun.
Love how this
and
turned out.
So, tomorrow again, another tomorrow. Next Wednesday at 6:30, we will be live again. And I'm sure we're going to do some more with the DSP because we're in love with this DSP.
Mm-hmm. It's so pretty.
It is.
It's so shiny.
All right, y'all. Have a great evening. We're going to go and relax and get over with our day.
Joe says broadcast is interrupted. It's really buffering tonight for me.
I'm so sorry, y'all. Okay, well, we're going to go. Hopefully, it'll work its bugs out and you'll be able to see it. Take care, and thanks for spending a little time in our stamping spot.
Please.
Bye.